Donald Trump has emerged from the White House for the first time since riots shook Washington DC visiting the border wall in Mexico.
Now, this comes as tensions grow in the capital amid warnings the violence could be repeated at Joe Biden's inauguration. We're joined now live from Washington DC by former US government official Miles Taylor. Miles, thank you for being with us. The House is of course expected to vote shortly on a resolution pressuring Mike Pence to invoke that 25th Amendment and remove Trump from office. Is there any chance, do you think, the Vice President will follow through here?
Well, Matt and Nat, I think at this point it's pretty clear that it's unlikely that Mike Pence, the Vice President of the United States, is going to decide to get a majority of the president's cabinet in favor of his imminent removal. I spent a lot of time with Vice President Pence when I worked in the Trump administration, and if there's one thing that's true about his tenure, he very rarely, if ever, deviates from the president. He's been a stalwart supporter, or some people would go as far as to say derisive things like a bootlicker. He does not deviate from Donald Trump, and I think it's extraordinary to believe that we would actually see Mike Pence do the ultimate deviation from his boss and suggest his ouster through the 25th Amendment. So, Matt and Nat, that's unlikely to happen. What I do think is quite likely is that the House will then move forward with these impeachment articles against Donald Trump.
Yeah, so talk us through the timeline of those impeachment articles. How long is that process? Because he's only got a week left.
Well, there's a big difference between this impeachment of Donald Trump and what happened almost exactly a year ago in the House of Representatives when they impeached him about a phone call to Ukraine, where he was trying to pressure the Ukrainians to investigate his political rival, Joe Biden. And the difference is this. Right now, the American people have already decided they want Donald Trump to leave office. Back then, the American people hadn't voted. And so now it's really a question of, do they accelerate the timeline for Donald Trump's departure and also at the same time prevent him from getting another term? So I think you're going to see this move even more quickly than the last impeachment. In a matter of days, I suspect, you'll have the House of Representatives debating this, and then it could go over to the Senate very soon. But what will happen is it will slow down dramatically in the United States Senate, and it's unlikely that Donald Trump would be impeached and removed before he's slated to leave office next Wednesday on January 20th, when the handover happens to Joe Biden.
There still be some conjecture, though. 75 million Americans still voted for him, so watch that space. The FBI has announced today hundreds of rioters will be charged in the coming weeks, but has also warned of more insurrection in the lead-up to Joe Biden's inauguration. Just how serious is this threat? How serious are authorities taking this threat?
Well, when I was in the Trump administration, I oversaw our largest law enforcement department, the Department of Homeland Security, with 250,000 people. And I've stayed in regular touch with top law enforcement and Homeland Security officials in the United States. And I'll tell you, they are very concerned, Matt. In fact, today, a top FBI source messaged me and said, we are, quote, stretched extraordinarily thin leading into these potential protests next week. They're expecting armed protests in all 50 capitals of the states in the United States. That's very concerning. If there's one word I could use to sum this up, America right now is a powder keg. And it's something that we're going to be watching closely, and law enforcement is going to be out in full force.
This is a huge worry, isn't it? You know, after last week. Miles Taylor, we really thank you for your insight this morning. And then the New York Times is now reporting breaking news this morning that FBI officials in Virginia wrote a warning the day before those Capitol riots. It didn't get passed on. I don't know where that memo went, but the head of the FBI in Washington said he didn't know anything about
that. That's almost impossible to believe, isn't it?
It is impossible.
But we've also said it was impossible to believe just how unprepared they were.
Exactly.
Hopefully we're better prepared for the inauguration, but 15,000 National Guard members they're talking about. Incredible.